Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, hey friend, my name is Kyra Oni. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button, and while you're there, click the bell icon so that you're notified on each and every single one of my videos. So today, you guys, we're making a lampshade for my dining room because I know y'all saw the before. It was ugly, you know, it didn't bring much to the room, and it also narrowed the lighting. It just wasn't really good, you know, it just wasn't with the vibes of my apartment. So we're gonna be making our own today because lampshades are expensive. Side note, people are high key scamming people with lampshades because $50, the ones that I was looking at, like, that's too much. That's absolutely too much. But anyways, we're not talking about that. We're talking about how we're making this lampshade. So this lampshade, I took inspiration from a Pinterest photo. It was actually on a floor lamp, but I thought it would look good as like a, you know, a ceiling lampshade. And I feel like it came out pretty good as far as the vibe and, you know, looking real cute. So yeah, we're gonna start off with an embroidery hoop. So we're gonna start off with the embroidery hoop that you guys see on the screen right now. Mine is 18 inches. Get two and use the two inner loops so that you don't have to go through the pain of resizing it and all this other stuff, because you can resize it down, but the shape will not be the same. So we're gonna go ahead, I spray and painted everything, including the dowels, which I got from Dollar Tree. And now we're going to size them down, and I am cutting mine using pruning shears. And also, side note, another tangent. Excuse my table, you guys. This is like a cheap Walmart table, and mine came with like white specks on it, and it's very hard to clean no matter how much I scrub, but you know, it doesn't even go in my apartment anyway, so you already know. This is foreshadowing for another DIY. But anyways, now that I got that out of the way, we can go ahead and start on construction. So we're going to glue our dowels first. You guys see me use E6000 glue, and now I'm pulling out my trusty hot glue gun. Do not use E6000 unless you really want to wait a long time and take the time to carefully tape everything down. At least with this project specifically, it was a lot for me to use E6000, but also, you know, I want to get this content out for you guys consistently, so I don't have the luxury to wait 24 hours for one thing to dry and then wait another 24 for the other half to dry. So I use hot glue. But also, I will say, because my outer hoop was not the right shape, it wasn't the same shape, it did put stress on my dowels, which made some of them start to fail. So what I would recommend if you use hot glue is to put nails in. I don't know if it was specifically because of the shape of the outer hoop, that's what I can assume, because that's what makes the most sense to me. But even if you did use the inner hoops, there's nothing wrong with some more reinforcement, so just go ahead, and I would recommend you definitely use the nails. And I would also recommend that you guys use some clamps. So, you know, because this is a circle, essentially, it will roll. And so I use my clamps to not only keep the stuff in place while it was curing, which definitely helped me, it also kind of stopped the lampshade from going all over the place. So I would recommend that. Now, you guys see I have some jewelry string on the hoops, and listen, don't do that. I wanted to use it because since I'm using mesh fabric, I didn't want the attachments to be noticeable. However, it was not a good time. It was so hard to kind of center it without it just keep bouncing and bouncing and bouncing. So go ahead and use some jewelry wire. I'm using some that I just had around the house. Make sure that it is thin. This is something that I had in my stash, so I do not know the gauge, unfortunately, but definitely, you know, especially if you could go to the store, you know, do whatever, if you feel so comfortable to kind of see what the different gauges are like. You want something that is not too big, but also not too thin, that it'll be super hard to level it. So I'm using my jewelry pliers with this. And when you're cutting your stuff, definitely make sure that you cut the wire longer than what you think, because when I originally put it up, it was too high, and I didn't realize it until after I went down and I turned my light on to, you know, just see what it looks like. So definitely make sure you have more than what you think. And also, the way that the wire is situated, this is the bottom wire, or bottom hoop, sorry. So put the wire on the bottom hoop because it'll make it a lot easier for you to center everything, make everything all even. So I did that, and I used four. Now, the more that you use, the easier it'll be to make it center. However, like I said, I'm using mesh fabric. If you're using opaque fabric, you don't have to worry about this. But using the mesh fabric, the less you use, the less detectable it is, if that makes sense. So I only use four. If you want to use five or six or seven or whatever more, feel free, but this is what worked for me. So now we're gonna go ahead and get to our wrapping. So I'm using some mesh tulle that I got from JoAnn Fabrics. It comes on a spool. This one I got was definitely too small. At the time, none of the stores were open, so I had to buy it online. However, I found a bigger length or a longer length, and it's also a wider tulle, and it comes with enough for you to do two layers. So I did two layers because I felt like it was too sheer once I did the first one, but I'm gonna put y'all on game real quick. So I'm gonna link the bigger one down below. And if you guys have, if you subscribe to their mailing list, and I think you could probably get it if you go on their website, they have a 50% off coupon. So you can get one of them half off. It's $10. And so you'll get it for $5. Listen, I'm putting y'all up on game. You welcome. You welcome. But anyways, yeah. So I go ahead and I do my first layer. That's what that looks like. And now we're gonna have to go back in. And this is the tool that I went out and got because I needed more. And I did my second layer. Now, when it comes to wrapping, you guys can kind of see, I tried my best to show this, but it was a lot to kind of wrap. As I am going along the side of the lampshade, I twist it. And then I go under and then I twist it again and I come up. And I thought that this pattern was very like unique, very nice. I don't know. I thought it just gave it some more texture than some basic wrapping and, you know, just super, super duper sheer. It gave it some texture. And also with doing this, it allowed me to really manipulate the mesh to cover the wire so that when you're looking from the outside, you don't see any wire. And also, side note, speaking of wire, I want to add some type of frosted material to the bottom so that it does cover the wires, because since it is under my dining room table, you know, when you're sitting there, when you're sitting at the table, you can see it. So just to cover it up, that's something that I'm gonna do. I didn't do it in this video because I didn't find the material, but I did want to let you guys know to do that, or, you know, give that to you guys as an option. So that, you know, if you wanted to cover up the bottom and you didn't want people to see all up inside your business, you can go ahead and cover that up. So once I finish everything, I'm gonna seal it off with some glue. And I only did the ends. That was like the first time and first and only time that I put glue on the fabric. It was very easy for me to wrap it up. And, you know, if you wrap it, not necessarily tightly, but well enough, that tight enough that it all stays, you'll only have to glue one end. So now this is what it looks like. And so now we can go to the fun part and attach it. So first things first, take off your old fixture. So this is my old fixture. I know you guys, is not cute. It's okay. But take off your old fixture. And also I do want to say, if you have smart home products like me, I'm using the same light bulbs that I use in my ostrich lamp video. Go ahead, make sure that you turn off your switch, because, you know, if you have a smart home device, you have to keep it on in order for Google Home or Alexa to, you know, control it. So you guys saw me point to the loop on my lights, and that's what we're going to use to make sure that this is attached securely. So go ahead and do two by two, you know, I have four, so I use two from one side and two from the other to even one side, and then pull up the other side to make it even out. And so when you do all that and make sure it's all level, this is what it looks like. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and I will see you guys next week. Peace.